Welcome friends, this is Current Affairs Funda and today we will discuss some important part of number system. Okay, so guys, before going our next series, I'll tell you about our channel. Basically, we are delivering free education for all of you, and guys, this is the request from this YouTube channel to you. Spread the word among your friends and share for those people who are preparing from home and can't afford the coaching classes. And guys, you know, learning is priceless. That's why I'm telling you, so do it now. And guys, if you want any specific topic video, then please do comment on our Facebook channel. This is facebook.com/currentaffairsfunda CF. And guys, do subscribe right now, because if you subscribe this channel, then you will directly notified from this YouTube channel. Okay, so this is the basic introduction about our channel. And now guys, let's move for our number system section. Okay, see, so today I'll discuss the cyclicity section. Cyclicity, what is the actual meaning of cyclicity, and how it will beneficial for you to solving the number system problems. Suppose guys, a question come in mind, like find the unit digit. Okay, find the unit digit. Okay, I'll solve the few examples after this session, and then I'll tell you the nature of questions. Okay, so if you need to find the unit place, then cyclicity directly benefit for you. Okay, so let's discuss the cyclicity of all the numbers. Okay, see guys, first one, that is cyclicity of 1. Cyclicity of 1. Okay, so cyclicity of 1 always 1. Why? Because the power of 1, it will be 1, and the power of 2, it will be 1, and the power of 3, it will be 1 up to. So you will get all the times as a result, that is 1 1, so cyclicity will definitely 1. Okay, and next, that is cyclicity of 2. Okay, so guys, in the upcoming section, I'll use a capital C for cyclicity. Okay, see, cyclicity of 2, that means 2's power 1, that is 2, and 2's power 2, it will be 4, and 2's power 3, it will be 8, and 2's power 4, it will be 16. Okay, and 2's power 5, it will be 32. Okay, see, you are getting the unit place, that is 2, you are getting the unit place, that is 4, you are getting the unit place, that is 8, and you are getting the unit place, that is 6. And guys, you are again getting the unit place, that is 2. That means repeating the cycles once again. That's why I'll avoid this one. Okay, so the cyclicity will be 4. So if I am asking a question to you, what is the cyclicity of 2, then you will definitely say the cyclicity of 2 will be 4. Okay, now decode all the cyclicities in the same manner. Cyclicity of 3. Okay, the cyclicity of 3, it will be 3's power 1, 3 up to power 2, 3's power 3, and 3's power 4. Now calculate all the powers. 3's to power 1, that is 3, 3's to power 2, that is 9, and 3's power 2, that is 27, and 3's power 4, it will be 81. Okay, and again, if you are solving the 3's power 5, this cycle will definitely repeat. Okay, that's why I am avoiding the last one. So the power So the unit place will be 3, and this unit place will be 9, this unit place will be 7, and this unit place will be 1. So the cyclicity of 3 will be 4, again 4. So cyclicity of 2 and 3 will be 4. Okay, so guys, let's move for the cyclicity for 4. Okay, so the 4 cyclicity will be 2. Why? See, 4 is to power 1, that is 4, and 4 is to power 2, it will be 16. Okay, and 4 up to power 4, it will be 64. So you are getting the unit place, that is 4 from here, and you are getting the unit place, that is 6 from here, and you are again getting the unit place, that is 4 from here. So avoid the last one, that's why it will be 2. Okay, so this is the best way to calculate the cyclicity. So guys, I'm calculating this one, power 1 up to 4, power 2, that is 16, it means 4. So guys, finally my motto is to learn you, motto is to teach you, that means cyclicity of 2, that is 4. It doesn't matter what the cyclicity, like 2, 4, 8, 6, it doesn't matter. You just need to remember the cyclicity of 2, that is 4 only. Okay, and the cyclicity of 3, it will be 4, and cyclicity of 4, it will be 2. Okay, so one thing more, I am writing here also, that means 2, 4, 8, 6. You can match with your calculations. 3, 9, 7, 1. Again guys, there will be a repetition of again 3, 9, 7, 1, again 3, 9, 7, that's why I am writing only once. Okay, and the cyclicity of 4, it will be 2, because 4 and 6. Okay, and cyclicity of 5, it will be 5 only, it will be 5. Okay, so cyclicity of 5 will be 1. Okay, because you will get the cycle, repeating cycle, it will be 5 only. And cyclicity of 6, it will definitely 1, because you will get every time 6, that means 6 power 6, 6 up to power, that is 36, again 6, again 6, that means the power, that is 6 only the unit place. Okay, and the cyclicity of 7, it will be 4. The numbers in the repeating section, it will be 7, 9, 3, 1. If you are applying like 7 is to power 1, it will be 7, 7 is to power 2, it will be 49, that means 9 is the unit place, that's why. And the cyclicity of 8, it will be 4, again 4. So the numbers will be 8, 4, 2, 6. Okay, and the cyclicity of 9, it will be 2, 9, and 1. Okay, and cyclicity of 10, guys, it will be 0, because it will be 1, because you are getting only 0 in the unit place. Okay, number will be 0. Okay, so this is your number and this is your cyclicity. Okay, so you should memorize this table. See, 2, 3, and 7, and 8, these cyclicity, that is 4. Okay, and 1, 5, 6, and 10, these cyclicity will be 1. Okay, and rest will be 2, that is 4 and 9. Okay, so it's all about the brief description. Okay, so guys, keep write down all these things, because I'm going to solve few examples on the basis of these cyclicities. It will definitely hit in your railway exams. For the perspective of railway exam, this video lesson is really, really very important. Okay, so keep write down. Now see, One thing more, guys. If you are dividing by 4, if you are dividing by 4 only, okay, then if remainder, then if remainder is 1, then power will be 1. Keep write down this thing. I'll tell you what is the actual meaning of this one, okay? And if you are dividing a number by 4, then if the remainder is 1, that means power will be 1. And if the remainder, that is 2, then power will be 2, okay? And if remainder will be 3, and then the power will be 3, okay? And the next condition, if the remainder, that is 0, that means no remainder, no remainder, so power will be 4, okay? So this is the basic structure that I have written here, so keep write down. So now, guys, let's